Still more corporate stories. GD Capital is cautiously optimistic for the company's growth this year following a record performance in 2023. GT Capital EVP and CFO Francisco Suarez Jr. sought to temper investor expectations on the back of still high interest rates. He adds the company is also gearing up for the Philippines' move from lower middle income to becoming an upper middle income country.
This is translated in terms of per capita income. Currently, our the Philippines per capita income is about 3,500, 3,600 per capita. Now, in the next 2 to 3 years, we expect per capita income to exceed 4,000 per capita. And by that time, assuming the Philippines is able to achieve that, then we expect the Philippines to be upgraded into an upper middle income country. That's why we're very bullish about the future. So aside from the five core businesses that we are involved, so we want to expand our involvement into other sectors. We're quite bullish on healthcare. Healthcare because of, well, we have a rising population and also a portion of that population is an aging population. These are seniors, age 65 and over. So, and then moving forward, we expect the aging population to account for about 20% of our total population from the current 10%. And then, of course, we also have the rising affluence, the rising income. So that's why people nowadays are more aware of health and wellness.
World Bank keeps its 2024 economic growth forecast for the Philippines at 5.8%. This as it sees developing East Asia and Pacific nations sustaining their growth amid global headwinds. But the global institution says while the region is expanding faster than the rest of the world, that growth is slower than it was before the COVID pandemic. It sees regional growth easing to 4.5% this year from 5.1% last year. The World Bank says countries in the region can sustain their growth momentum by opening more activities to private sector investment, resolving financial sector challenges, and boosting productivity. The Philippine ICT Department confirms an increase in cyber attacks, as well as misinformation and disinformation on social media since last year. This comes as Texas-based cybersecurity firm CrowdStrike warned. The Philippines faces growing threats from China-backed hackers. In its 2024 Global Threat Report, CrowdStrike said these Chinese hackers are now using generative artificial intelligence for surveillance and intellectual property theft in Southeast Asia. The DICT says local hackers also pose a threat. It believes the spread of misinformation and disinformation on social media sites is linked to next year's midterm polls.
A lot of disinformation is going to increase in the social media sites, especially in Facebook and in TikTok, going to the 2025 elections. You see this already being practiced or experimented on journalists. There are a lot of robocalls or fake videos being generated, mimicking journalists and even our past presidents and our incumbent presidents. And we advise the public to be more vigilant with disinformation and misinformation. Please do not use Facebook. Please do not use TikTok as your source of news. The motivation is usually to affect the outcome of the election in order to put leaders who are more sympathetic to their cause.